Tell Down Therapy. Oh, yeah.
Hello, you, for watching this video. First, I want to say thanks to my first and only subscriber. Thank you, Mom. On this beautiful day, we will tear down 3 inkjet printers. We have white Lexmark X2620, black Epson SX105 and HP D1360, which is gray. I managed to get 3 different printers of different manufacturers and 3 different exterior colors. Yes, I'm very lucky man. I'm putting my gloves before disassembling because inkjet printers have colors all over interior, and according to previous experience, the skin easily absorbs that color that stays with you for days. We are starting with the smaller one, HP, then Lexmark, and then we will finish it with Epson. The second half of the video, I'll talk about things you can get after you tear down one of them. For now, while I'm disassembling them, let's talk a little bit about how they work, or how does printing head move. The bigger printers and newer ones can have stepper motors. In this printer we have normal DC motor and rotary encoder disc. They are attached on shaft. The output of encoder indicates the current shaft position. The optical encoder disc is made of glass, or in this case plastic, with transparent and non-transparent black area. Here on picture you can see how they look. This is complete mechanism with rotary encoder disc, photo sensor, shaft, gears and DC motor. Photoelectric sensors are composed of a phototransistor and LED. A light source and photodetector array read the optical pattern that results information from the disc's position at any one time. And here is a beautiful picture in which you can see how simple the schematic of the sensor is. As long as the phototransistor is not exposed to light, the resistance on its emitter collector is several kiloohms. Whenever the light hits the phototransistor, the resistance drops. Sometimes, instead of rotary encoder disks, you can find single-track encoders, like we have in first HP Gray printer. Let's talk a little bit about print heads, and about two types of them. We have thermal one and piezo inkjet print head, which is currently used in Epson inkjet printers. Piezo print heads don't use heat to force ink out of the nozzle. Instead, they use a thin film that forces the ink from the nozzle onto the paper. The film is exposed to electric charge that causes film to vibrate, building up the pressure. Piezo print heads are compatible with a wide range of inks, since they don't use heat in printing process. These print heads are used in plotters, and why are they using mostly in plotters is that they can print signs and banners because they can use solvent eco oil based ink, which is more durable for items that will be outside. Thermal ink print heads currently used in HP inkjet printers use heat and water based inks for printing. The head is used to boil the ink and create air bubble of ink vapor. The air bubble is then exploded as it forced through the print head nozzle. Once the ink is expelled, the chamber cools down and the process repeats. I was surprised how easy it was to get at the inside of some of them, and the amount of goodies you can get from them, like there is DC motors for paper feed, for head movement, turning shafts and units for moving the printhead, rails and belts. The scanning assembly contains stepper motors built into the scanner, and there is also toothed belt with a nice sliding rage and pulley. What you can find also in this printer is several rotary encoder sensors, a linear encoder sensor, a few photo interrupter sensors, and a couple of switches. Great assortment of gears come in printers. Many of them lock onto the metal and plastic shafts, providing a ready-made solution for some future projects or applications. In the top circuit board you can find push switches, LEDs, 7-segment displays and a few other smaller components which you can reuse. A small but sophisticated amount of circuitry is built into the printer to control all the mechanical aspects of operation, as well as decode the information sent from the printer to the computer. You can get from it nice amount of capacitors, smaller and surface mount electronics, and also connectors for all the wires. While earlier printers often had external transformer, most printers sold today use a standard power supply that is incorporated into the printer itself, as in Epson printer. There is also glass from the scanner unit, plastic holders and cases, wires, flat cables, which have some potential for future projects. Okay, now I have the parts. I need to figure out how to use them. So do you, if you consider to tear them for parts. The problem with reusing some of them is lack of documentation. But most of the things is using standard voltage, 3.3, 5 and 12 volts. There is huge potential for reusing parts in printer and learning from them, especially if you are in robotics or in Arduino or Raspberry Pi. It is always nice to see others salvaging perfectly good parts and using them for things rather than dumping them. Of course, be careful and use precaution measures and safety equipment. Hope you like the video. If not, write me in comments what I can change. See you at the next Teardown Therapy.